Dennis, one of the first things I think is important to discuss for folks is why actually becoming a contributor makes sense. Adobe has made tools for years that help creative people. And I think a lot of folks, when they heard, oh, Adobe has stock, oh, that's going to be great for the designers and, you know, video editors who need to download clips. But you guys have put a lot of effort into the contributor side. Why does this make sense for someone to become a contributor, even if they might already have a full-time job as a video editor or a production person, a DP?
Sure. There's a lot of great answers around that. I mean, I think at the end of the day, philosophically, Adobe would love to be the company that is helping you make money through the use of our tools. And contributing to Adobe Stock can really be a great example of how to do that. So one of the things that I would first say about contributing to Stock is it's very easy to do. You can sign up, it's very simple. And the important point that I convey is it gives back exactly what you put into it. So for example, hey, everyone's got thousands and thousands of photos and videos, and I can go through those and upload some. And that's just kind of like, that's gonna give you some coffee money once in a while.
Right.
But other times, people are looking to become valuable or increase their career, move their career forward. They've invested maybe in a new camera, and they need to kind of recoup the investment on that. And this is a great opportunity where you take a little time. I want to become familiar with the camera. I just bought a new camera. Let me become familiar with it. Let me go out and do a scene, go to this location that I know about, shoot some footage. Hey, let's take the time, do the extra step, put it up to Adobe Stock. And what I've found through experiencing and talking with many, many contributors is that it starts to pay back. And then they start to realize, like, wow, I can do something with that. And now, today, we have a ton of contributors that are actually doing this full time. They realize they have a skill set for it. It enables them to do the other things that they want. Maybe it's a production company. Maybe it's shooting that documentary film. But the stock footage, in my case, but also images, vectors, 3D objects, all different kinds of content types, all of those can kind of pay you back and enable you to do what you love. Because at the end of the day, everyone that's here is really driven by the creativity. And this is a great way for you to enable your creativity and turn it around and have it work for you.
Well, and speaking of turning it around, I think a lot of folks struggle in the creative industry. You know, they want it, they have clients, they have jobs, they have projects they're focusing on. Mm-hmm. But I can tell you in our own shop with multiple bodies, there are times that we're really busy, and there are times that we're not as busy as I would like. And while everyone likes a quiet day every now and then to get cleaned up and get things put away, you have ebbs and flows in your natural business. You can take all of that equipment you've already invested and basically start producing your own shoots and monetizing it, right?
Sure, that's a great use case and example, because maybe you have a day gig and you're working for a production company, but you have your own camera, or you're a freelancer and you're doing some corporate gigs on Monday through Friday or something like that. Or to your point, you have a slow day or a few days. Again, it's a perfect opportunity for you to go out and do the shoot and do, you know, shoot whatever you want. You're becoming more familiar with the camera. And the idea is that you're building a residual income that is going to be paying you. So the idea that I get excited about is that, okay, I build up a catalog of content and it starts to work for me. And now it starts to pay me back. And so that if I'm making X amount of dollars with, say, 500 clips, well, if I double it to 1,000 clips, then suddenly it's starting to work that much more for me. And using that downtime is an extremely productive way for you to invest and see, is this going to work for me? And it, you know, you can do it on your own time, you're learning at the same time, and you're gaining exposure. That's another thing. It's, you know, as you build up a portfolio, you're building up exposure. You can point some of your clients, like, oh, you want to see an example of how I would light and shoot this? Well, go to Adobe Stock and see basically my portfolio of stuff.
And as you're building this out, you know, what are some of the basic financial models? So someone who is a video contributor and they are uploading content, obviously prices change and they might change in the future, but right now, what does a high definition video clip sell for on Adobe Stock?
So great question. And it really depends upon, obviously, with currencies, because we try and reflect local currencies and there's a number of them. But speaking in US dollars, Each HD clip licenses for $79.99. Mm-hmm. And then if you're shooting 4K, which again, most of the cameras that we have today, or you're going to buy a camera today, is going to be a 4K camera, it will be $199.99.
Okay. And Adobe then takes care of the hosting, you guys advertise, it's built right into the apps. So the contributor doesn't have to get involved in any of the customer service, but at the end of the day, they're still getting a cut of that money. What does a contributor tend to make percentage-wise off of the sale?
Sure, so every time, let's say I put up a clip there and someone downloads it, every time an HD clip sells, I get 35% of that royalty, same thing for 4K, so that roughly equates in dollars to $28 every time you sell a HD clip, and I think it's $70 every time you sell a 4K clip.
So if you were looking at your normal production day, you know, in my market, a director of photography, if they're on a paying gig, might make somewhere between $600 and $1,000 for a day. Well, if they've got a day off and they're just looking to get out there and practice and they have an opportunity to shoot something that's photogenic, that may actually turn into additional income. And it's income that can be earned when you're sleeping,
yep,
when you're on another job, when you are taking a vacation, right? Like once you've uploaded it, what's the contributor on the hook for? What do they need to do once they've submitted the clips? We'll talk more about the actual technical process, but there's not much that they need to do once it's monetized, right?
Right, you're absolutely right. And the idea, I remember when you said, you know, you're making money while you sleep. I remember a person who wrote a book about shooting stock footage. One of his quotes was like, he had made thousands of dollars sleeping, you know, during the 8 hours and woke up and was, you know, thousands of dollars richer. Now, obviously it depends upon the amount of content,
right,
the artistry, the you know, the kind of content that people want and need, but you're absolutely right. It starts to work for you and you do nothing else. Like you pointed out in the previous bit, which was like Adobe spends an enormous amount of money doing the marketing, hosting. You don't have to pay for storage costs. We do, you know, many Google and Bing and Yahoo AdWord key buys to make sure that Adobe Stock is servicing, so that when a customer says, I need a clip of whatever, and you have that clip, that clip is going to show up in the search results. People are going to want to buy it and license it. You're getting paid. You're making money.
Great. Well, up next, we're going to talk about what sort of things actually sell well on Adobe Stock and help you refine your plan for shooting so you are actually creating content that there is demand for in the market.